collect your breath. Let us pray together the collect appointed for this day. On page 2 of the bulletin. Let us pray. Jesus, when you rode into Jerusalem, the people waved palms with shouts of acclamation. Grant that when the shouting dies, we may still walk beside you, even to the cross. Amen. Let us be seated for the reading from God's Word. I notice Lauren's not here. Does someone want to read the song, lead the song for us?
Sure, I can.
Patty, you want to do that?
Sure.
Okay, thanks, Patty.
I'll be reading from Psalm 118. I'll read the light print, and you can respond with me in the dark print. Give thanks to our God who is good, whose mercy endures forever.
Let Israel now proclaim, your mercy endures forever.
Open for me the gates of righteousness. I will enter them. I will offer thanks to God.
This is the gate of our God. Those who are righteous may enter.
I will give thanks to you, for you answered me and have become my salvation.
The same stone which the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone.
This is your doing, O God, and it is marvelous in our eyes.
On this day our God has acted. We will rejoice and be glad in it.
Hosanna, Yahweh, Hosanna, O God, send us now success.
Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Holy One. We bless you from the house of our God.
God, our God, has shined upon us. Form a procession with branches up to the horns of the altar.
You are my God, and I will thank you. You are my God, and I will exalt you.
Give thanks to our God, who is good, whose mercy endures forever.
Glory to God, our Creator, to God's most holy word, and to the Spirit indwelling, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Became obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God also highly exalted him and gave him a name that is above every name, so that at the end, at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bend in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. To the glory of God, the Father, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand as you are able for the gospel.
You come into your kingdom, Jesus.
said this, he went on ahead, going up to Jerusalem. When he had come near Bethpage and Bethany, at the place called Mount of Olives, he sent two of the disciples, saying, "Go into the village ahead of you. As you enter it, you will find tied there a colt that has never been ridden. Untie it and bring it here. If anyone asks you, 'Why are you untying it?' just say, 'The Lord needs it.'" So those who were sent departed and found it as he had told them. As they were untying the colt, its owners asked them, "Why are you untying the colt?" They said, "The Lord needs it." Then they brought it to Jesus, and after throwing their cloaks on the colt, they set Jesus on it. As he rode along, people kept spreading their cloaks on the road. As he was now approaching the path down from the Mount of Olives, the whole multitude of the disciples began to praise God joyfully with a loud voice for all the deeds of power that they had seen, saying, "Blessed is the King who comes in the name of the Lord. Peace in heaven and glory in the highest heaven." Some of the Pharisees in the crowd said to him, "Teacher, order your disciples to stop." He answered, "I tell you, if these were silent, the stones would shout out." The Gospel of Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Here we are. We've arrived at last. We are at the door, the very door of our salvation. We have arrived, and the King is with us. What kind of future is waiting for us? What is waiting for us as we shout Hosanna? Those of us who have been around the block once or twice know what is coming next. We know about Thursday. We know about Friday. We know about Saturday, when God is absent from the world. But what if you didn't know? What if you had just paraded into Jerusalem and up the stairs of the temple? And if you believe that now our salvation has come among us? What if you didn't know about Thursday and Friday and Saturday? What do you hope that Jesus will do? What do you want Jesus to do? I want Jesus to stop the war, damn it. I want Jesus to feed those hungry people. I want Jesus to stop the cruelty, stop the racism, stop the homophobia, stop the hating. Jesus, if you're King, get on with it. So what kind of King is Jesus? What did this entry into Jerusalem mean? Can you imagine in your mind the entry of the great King, the Caesars of Rome, with all of their horses and their warriors, all of their prizes from war? What does it mean to enter victorious into your city? What kind of King then are we following? There's a word that I'd like to share with you. I didn't do so well in my Greek studies at VST, but I remember one word, which I'm now going to pronounce wrong, but dunamis is the translation, is power. So if we think of Jesus coming with power, if we think of Jesus being filled with the power of the Holy Spirit, what does Jesus do with that power? Casting out demons, healing those who are brokenhearted or broken in body or spirit. Jesus gives this power away to the 12 and then to the others in the further circle and finally to us. What does the dunamis of Jesus do? Is it the kind of power that comes in with bombs and missiles and swords? Or is it a totally different kind of power? The power to make things right. Jesus, we pray, make these things right. Make the wars to end. Make the famines to cease. Make the diseased heal. If we say, blessed is this King who comes in the name of the Lord, what do we mean? Wars, of course, are the delusions of mad men. Delusions of power that is not the power of God. Pope Francis said just this last week, from the east of Europe, from the land of the sunrise, the dark shadows of war have now spread. We had thought that invasions of other countries, savage street fighting, and atomic threats were grim memories of a distant past. However, the icy winds of war, which bring only death, destruction, and hatred in their wake, have swept down powerfully upon the lives of many people and affected us all. This is what happens when the sin of pride and greed overwhelm men and women. And in these times, we from the church have to name these things, have to name power, what it is and what it isn't. Francis then said, now in the night of the war that has fallen upon humanity, let us not allow the dream of peace to fade. And so this Palm Sunday, let us dream of peace. Let us put our hearts in the place of peace. Let us work for peace. Let us demand peace. Let us follow the Prince of Peace. This year, as every year, we begin Holy Week in praise of a King whose power is not tanks or fighter planes or drones or supersonic missiles. We see this week, this day, that the power of God, true power, is something that no army can ever do. To give life, not to destroy it. To change hearts, not to break them. To destroy the power of sin and death once and for all. The crowds in Jerusalem dreamed of victory and glory, of an end to occupation, and they hoped that Jesus would be the one to do this. Now, that wasn't quite what happened, but it is in the end where our hope and where our peace lies. Jesus is not of this world, in that he will not pull to himself these powers of sin and death that underlie all human empires. These are the enemy, sin and death. These are the ancient and most potent enemies of the whole human race. They have the power to break our hearts, to take our lives and the lives of those we hold dear. And these are the enemies that, through God's power, through our hands and our work, Jesus' death on the cross and his glorious resurrection can be proclaimed in every place. God says yes to Jesus' life, to Jesus' ministry, to Jesus' power. And God hands that power to us. Jesus' acts of power have been given to each one of you and to me at our baptism. And now we are charged, not Jesus. We are the ones to go out there and stop these wars, to stop the greed and the violence, the indifference and the hatred which lead to these wars. These doors that we opened today, our doors, our hearts are open. And so we will continue to shout Hosanna, even and especially in the places of darkness. Thanks be to God. Stand as you are able and say together with me the words of the Apostles' Creed. Let us affirm our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Now, I'd like to invite Roland forward, who's going to say the prayers of the people. So please stand, sit, or kneel, as is your custom for prayers.
People of God, let us continue our Lent journey by celebrating Christ's triumphant entry into Jerusalem. Let us take this moment to acknowledge all his sufferings and sacrifices he's made for us. Let us equally take this moment to uplift ourselves to God and to uplift those in need. At the end of each prayer, I will say, Lord, in your mercy, please respond me, hear our prayer. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us pray. Lord, you endured pain to set us free. You suffered so that we may be saved by your surpassing grace. You bled to wash away our sins. Lord, we have wronged you many times. We have often wronged one another, and we have often wronged ourselves. We pray that you wash away all our iniquities with your precious blood and grant us your grace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Jehovah, you were tried and tempted by all evil forces. May we never be ashamed of the temptation, but be resilient and saved from the weakness of giving in. Help us to stand for faithfulness rather than to go with the flow. Let us stand for sacrifice rather than take from the poor and needy. Help us to be more sensitive to your creation. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for the whole family of your church. May all your people be built up in faith and show their lives, and show in their lives the love which we see in Jesus. Help us to play our part in the life of the church throughout the world by our prayers and our thanksgiving. Give courage to those who find it hard to follow you. Give us vision that leads us to action. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord, we pray for all in positions of authority and leadership in every nation and community, that they may not misuse their powers, but use it for the betterment of their people. We pray for our church leaders. We pray for our diocesan leaders and for our leader enemy. Please grant them and their aides wisdom to lead their flock to you. Lord, in your mercy. Lord, we continue to pray and thank you for our community here at St. Barnabas. May your face be seen here in the works and actions of all here, through kindness, hospitality, friendship, and love. We thank you for sending us committed elders, deacons, and church helpers. We pray that you continue to give them wisdom and replenish their energy. Lord, in your mercy, Lord, we uplift to you, your people. We pray for those whose lives are blighted with sickness, whose lives are blighted with suffering, with death, addiction, anger, low self-esteem, poverty, and neglect. We pray grant them strength and that your children here at St. Barnabas be a beacon of hope to those in need in every small way we can. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord, we continue to uplift to you the people of Ukraine and all who suffer as a result of the war in Ukraine. We pray that all the affected be treated properly, irrespective of their ethnic origins. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord, your Son suffered and paid the ultimate price that we should be free. Please hear our petitions and prayers through your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen. Beloved ones in Christ, happy are those whose sins are forgiven, whose wrongs are pardoned. I will confess my sins to the Lord. I will not conceal my wrongdoings. God forgives and heals us. We need your healing, merciful God. Give us true repentance. Some sins are plain to us, some escape us, some we cannot face. Forgive us, set us free to hear your word to us, set us free to serve you. God forgives you. Forgive others, and forgive yourself. Through Christ, God has put away your sin. Approach your God in peace. Please stand as you are able. Beloved ones in Christ, may the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
say peace to one another. We're actually allowed to like do it the other way, but we've gotten kind of used to it this way. I have a question. Did anybody get a hymn book in there running around as we got in? Because I didn't make sure, but if you don't, wave your hand so we'll get you a hymn. Our offertory hymn today is... If you don't have a hymn book, wave your hands. Patty's got them. Number 184. My song is love. Oh, I got the wrong one. 86. Anybody need one? Six verses only? Okay. Sathya is letting me know. Six verses of this building.
Which verse?
I'll have to look. This day we are invited to share in the common cup again. So we will not be doing communion. I will take it to you individually, but we'll do it as we did in days of yore, where Martha and I will stand before you. We have bread and we have the communion hosts. You are invited to take one or other of those, and you do not have to take the wine. If it's just not the time for you, that's fine. You can acknowledge the cup, you can just bow, and you are welcome to share if you so wish. Another thing Satya pointed out to me late last night, I forgot page 6. we will go right from the Sursum Corda, or the Lord be with you prayer, and we will, you guys know it by heart, you guys know the Sanctus. As soon as you hear it, you'll just jump in. But don't be surprised, it's not in the bulletin. And just as a another renewal of things we've done in the past, we will be singing. I will be singing part of the Eucharistic prayer. So please join as you are able. Now let us say together the prayer over the gifts. Gracious God, the suffering and death of Jesus, your only Son, reminds us of the history of human sin. We know that alone we can do nothing, but through his revelation of love, we may receive your love and mercy. Amen.
The Lord be with you. And also
out of error into truth. out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, a death he freely accepted, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is broken for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink this, you do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, loving God, according to his command, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, and we await his coming in glory. And we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, God of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we, made acceptable in him, may be sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, reconcile all things in Christ and make them new, and bring us to that city of light where you dwell with all your sons and daughters through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation, by whom, and with whom, and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty God, now and forever. And now, as our Savior taught us, let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us.
Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread, communion in Christ's body once broken. Let your church be the wheat which bears its fruit in dying. If we have died with him, we shall live with him. If we hold firm, we shall reign with him. These are the gifts of God, and we are the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
So please come forward as you wish. We'll start with Safia.
Thank you.
Please stand as you are able. Let us say together the prayer after communion. Let us pray. God, our help and strength, you have satisfied our hunger with this Eucharistic food. Strengthen our faith that through the death and resurrection of your Son, we may be led to salvation, for he is Lord now and forever. Amen. Glory to God, whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to God from generation to generation, in the church and in Christ Jesus, forever and ever. Amen. I'm not going to make a lot of church announcements because I'm a little bit worried about the time. Our United Church friends are coming in pretty soon, so come over to the hall, have a cup of tea and a cup of coffee with us, and we'll share. Everything you need to know for Holy Week is on the back of your bulletin. So bring it home, stick it on the fridge, and I hope to see you all week long. And we have a special treat for my first time since I've been here at St. Barnabas. We fired up the organ and it didn't catch fire.
Wow.
So please stand as you are able. Our final hymn, 198, O Sacred Head Surrounded. 198. understanding. Keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and in the love of God and of God's Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, Mother, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you this day and forevermore.
Amen. Go forth in peace and love, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit.
Thanks be to God.
We have a special guest here who slipped in unannounced. You're just hiding. Are you coming for coffee?